Hello and welcome back to Mordheim, City of the Damned. We've just suffered a bad defeat at the hands of the sisters. We were scattered all over the place, and our key elements of our warband were massively out of position at the start. Not really much we could do about it, but fortunately we didn't have too many injuries. We ended up losing Kales entirely. He wasn't dead, he was just so badly injured I fired him on the spot and hired a replacement. So that being said, let's have a look at what's on the cards for today. So we've got a Weirdstone rush here with a poor amount of Weirdstone. That doesn't sound great to me. The poor amount of Weirdstone means that we'll get between only 13 and 18 nodes, which is probably not great as far as actually trying to build up our supplies again goes. Average is between 15 and 20, so that's at least more worth our while, and it's actually just better overall. Yeah, so out of these two, I'd definitely go for this one. Well, the alternative is a crush their will with an average amount of Weirdstone in as well. Given these options, I think we're going to go for this middle one. And I think we'll take the exact same lot as last time. We need to give Duradash a new weapon because he got robbed at the end of the last game. He got taken out of action and the sisters, bastards that they were, went through and stole all of his stuff. Where are you, Duradash? Well, they didn't quite steal everything, but they stole enough. There you go, axe and shield. Just double check that everyone else is actually equipped properly. Axe and shield as well. Svogaz, arms, yes. Bow, good. Right. On with the show.
Your scouts have discovered a rival warband in the vicinity. These warriors are clustered around their wagon, making them a very attractive target.
So, 55% of Weirdstone is our objective. Where are they? We've got a big pile here. That looks like, four. Another big pile here. This is the key point to aim for. In fact, that's probably where most of the engagement's going to happen. It looks like we're up against the human mercenaries again. So if I can get Svogaz to come down this way and up here, we can sort of secure this area and this at the same time. The alternative is to barrel him up here and then down this way. But I think if there's an option down here, that's going to be our better one. So that's one, that's two, and everything else is so scattered around it's not worth marking. Yeah, I think this is probably your best option. So you go there, we'll put Dagom with you as support. As I see in, why not? You can lead the charge on the other side, supported by Farik, Rytosh, Duradash, and Azdon. So guys, let's see what you can find. Don't get too far ahead though, just want to secure the area initially. Left, then a right. Over there, yes. Well, this is a fairly good point to wait. If we sit just around this corner, it's very unlikely that they'll be able to reach us so quickly. But if they do, we'll sneak out and attack them. And we get eyes in most directions. Tagom, I think you can run through this building and save yourself a little bit of time. Yes, you can. Nothing worthwhile in that building, though. So just get yourself in a position to support Svogaz. 90% success chance now. Ah, that improvement is great. Of course, it does now have a greater Dzench curse chance, which is not good. I'm going to have to get him a better staff so that things like that doesn't happen. Anyway, ambush dance for now. As I see in. We'll just bomb you forwards and turn right at the end, I think. Or up through here. No, we can't. Don't think we can get through here properly. Oh, yes we can. Well, that's going to save us a small amount of time. No point in doing any poison globe or anything. Just go on ambush stance for the moment. Poison globes could be good as area denial in a PvP game. The AI largely ignore them, so they're more suited for just area damage. Now, the human mercenaries are already picking up weird stones, so they're probably here. Expect them sort of to be feeding up through those streets over there. Farik, you can go and support Zycian. Can't move quite as far. Just go on Overwatch here. And we'll get Rytosh to chase and support as well. Rytosh, new blood, no skills, no anything really. Pretty much just going to use him to carry things, I expect. And you two, you can probably go and support Svogaz. He does like a friend or two. And act as some more eyes in the area. And carrying capacity, of course, for the Weirdstone. We need to pick up 10 points worth, as in 10 items worth of Weirdstone. In order to achieve the secondary objective this time. That's going to be 4 from here. 4 from here, and then 2 more. We can already see one of their henchmen. Maybe we can get the other 2 off the corpses of our foes. That would be very good for us. But we'll see how the plan holds up when we actually get to engage the enemy. Can see the first of them over there in the distance on that ledge just above our shoulder. Asdon can see you. Can we see anyone else? No, we can't. Not yet, anyway. So if they're partway up the building, Svogaz is not going to be able to engage them just yet. Maybe he can charge in on the ground level.
A new round has started.
You can see some more people. Ugh, stupid traps. Right, who's that guy? Ah, it's a wolf priest of Ulrich. Okay, he's just a hero. There's a guy just up there. Oh, that's that guy. Yeah, we knew he was there. Who else is around? More guys further back. Okay, that's marksman. We could charge up here. No, we can't. You're too big, or he's in the way. One or the other. Either way makes for a sad Svogaz. Is there anyone else around whom you could engage with? Taking it a little bit cautiously, because we don't want to end up completely swarmed. But maybe we should just charge at their wolf priests. For the moment, sort of moving back to here where we started, and I'm just going to delay for a moment. Slow ourselves down, let them come to us a little. So we'll have to go and buff up our guys again. So first of all, weapons of destruction on Svogaz. Because he's definitely going to want it. And then we'll put it on probably Duradash, but we won't put it on anyone because we've stunned ourselves. Well, that's ruined that plan. As I see in. Come and pick up the things, please. little bit concerned he's out in the open a bit, but we'll be able to grab these three.
Objectives updated.
And then we could throw a poison globe in sort of this direction and block off their approach.
Objectives updated.
We could even switch to our warplock pistols and like try and get some high ground, pretend we're an archer.
Objectives updated.
That's three down, seven to go. And still just enough move to get out of the way for someone else. So we're going to poison globe over here just to block off this entire area. I think that's probably good enough. Farik, you're stuck. Just delay then for the moment, please. Svogaz, I'm going to ask you to delay again as well, actually. Just wait a little bit. They'll come closer, then you can have fun. And really, I want this guy who's coming up that slope to decide to jump down at us. Nope, he's decided to stay up there. Fine. I'm sure Svogaz can make that work somehow. Farik, you're still stuck. Just wait here for the moment. We'll get your friends out of the way soon enough. Svogaz, charge forwards. I think you're going to go after that guy that's just shot at you. You're not going to get your defense, which is always a massive pain. The other option is we could... Yeah, no, actually, it's probably worthwhile just for one turn. Don't think we can manage it any other way. If you come this way, you're not going to be in charge range, despite how much I really want you to be. No, not quite. You can get to here and be in charge range. Or just wander in and do a lot of hurt. That's what you're going to do. He can't retreat. You're probably going to kill him very quickly anyway. Oh, he's one of their heroes. He is a young blood. Ah, I had just assumed he was a regular goon. No, just do a regular attack now. And then end your turn. And we're going to try and bring some support forwards for you. We'll send Juradash and Asdon up to sort of try and flank the area. Just because he doesn't have any defense on this turn for the moment. This guy... Pick up this last bit of Weirdstone and then come around to the side, try and join in the fight this way. So we're going to go sort of here-ish and then ambush stance. Juradash is putting himself in a slightly worse position to try and save Svogaz a little there. Farik. Which is going to be the fastest way to get you into a useful position. Maybe straight through the building even. Yeah, you don't have anything to shoot yet. Hopefully soon. And Asdon... Well, you may as well pick these up as you're passing. We do need them after all. And of course, all of these negative weird stone effects are bad for us in combat. But they usually only last two turns. They're not all bad. They're just mostly bad. These ones, yeah, these ones are really bad. All of those stats down. Take Asdon like a turn or two until he's useful in combat again. Alright, Marksman's turn. Ah, he's going high. That's fine. Don't care about that so much. Especially when he then runs down the stairs at us. I'm mostly concerned about that Wolf Priest of Ulrich coming round. Okay, he's gone very high. We're definitely not going further that way. No point walking into a trap after all. Ah, they're impressive. Oh, I really hope he can't reach us. Oh, phew. And their Wolf Priest is stupid, apparently. Trying to cast Winter's Chill. And buffing their Impressive. That's not great. Good work there, Juradash. And nice dodge, kind of, as well. Yeah, get a counterattack in. Alright, you missed, but, you know, the fact that you saved Svogaz from being pounded on. Ha, I'm not the only person to suffer from traps. That is a big old sword, though.
A new round has started.
Right, problems to deal with. Number one, Lurk Bowler. Okay. Number two, Wolf Priest Guy. That's a good hit. Just a regular attack. Nice. And then finally we can go on sidestep. To go on. You've actually been more of a hindrance than a help this game so far. Pick up the weird stone. And then you can go and buff Juradash and then Svogaz. I hope. The other benefit of getting this up to mastery is the improved range on it. The reason I went, oh, just then, is of course he... just picked up a bit of a weird stone and now it's apparently given him more offensive points required to cast stuff. So I can do one or the other. I think Juradash is going to... No, it's always going to be Svogaz. Svogaz just does so much more. Like, double down on your heavy hitters. The swinginess of this game can largely be... manipulated by focusing on the fewest number of hits taken to kill an enemy. So if you can get it down to one or two swings to win, you're going to be in a much, much better position than someone that needs five or six. Now, where can I get that poison globe to? Nowhere useful there. I can do it there. And then go on ambush stance. Freak! Come and do some arching, please. Can we get anywhere useful? Up in that building would be good. So, is there a side door? No, there is not. Okay. Up there would be good, but we can't actually get there. Guess we're just charging to the front lines then. Get two shots from here. Ah, that guy? It's possible, certainly. I'd rather get some shots at the Wolf Priest guy. Something like this, I think. There we go. It's not a great chance to hit, but it is a chance to hit. And a reload. Another shot. And then we'll retreat out of sight a little. We'll reload again next turn. Goody, more traps. He doesn't want to jump down into the poison, which is a reasonable stance to have. Get Rytosh to come up here and be a bit of a blocker. So you can just sit here on ambush stance. In case anyone tries to run past the Juradash Svogaz combat going on. So Juradash, take this guy out. Good. Then I'm not entirely sure what I want to happen next. I think baiting their leader into attacking is probably the best thing to do. And I say best things in the very loosest sense of the word. So we're going to sneak forwards a smidgen, try and loot this guy, steal his great axe. And then I'm going to move out of Svogaz's sphere of influence. And try and get to a point where just their leader comes over. Come on. Come on. Come on. I think you're on ambush. Ouch. This has backfired horrifically. Hey, don't be shooting Svogaz. Oh, that is not cool. Oh man, I'm sorry, Juradash. That's really bad for you. I'm hoping that their impressive goes after Svogaz rather than Juradash. Oh, right on his head. Yep. Sorry, Juradash. And then who are you going after? Rytosh. Good work. Yeah, this might be bad for you as well, but keep trying. We'll get Svogaz to turn around immediately and help out. If he can, if you survive, you might not survive. Oh, bum.
Objectives updated.
Sure, everyone who's on ambush, just charge in. Don't worry about the fact that all of your friends have slowly gone out of action. 2-on-1 then to start with. Get Azdon just to walk in and get a couple of hits. This is their leader. If we can get him out of action, then Morel's going to take a particularly large hit. Go on, parry stance. What you're best at the moment with all of your reduced stats.
A new round has started.
Now, Svogaz, what do you want to do? Go after their impressive? He's got 494 health. That is a really, really large amount. Let's take you round after their leader instead first. So start with Blood Offering. And then get a couple of nice, really solid hits. Please hit. And then go on sidestep. To Gom at this stage. Weapons of destruction on Svogaz, I guess. And then probably Zycian, I think. And after that, hide, I guess. Let's just wait back here. This seems like a safe-ish place to be, so just sit here on dodge. Zycian. Poison Globe first, then attack. So Poison Globe over here. I know the Impressive has a very, very high poison resistance, but it doesn't hurt to try. And then attack. Good hit. Go on, dodge. Yep. He still doesn't want to jump down into that poison cloud. Freak. Reload. Now, can you take out their leader? Who do you want to shoot from here without moving? Oh, that guy. Okay. No. I think I want you to go after the leader. But do it as an aimed shot. Great. Now, target choice is entirely yours. Aimed shot against the big guy. It's not going to do a huge amount of damage. We'll do considerably more against that guy, but he doesn't seem keen to engage us in a fight. So, yeah, go after the big giant ogre. And then just end your turn. The marksmen are going to have to come forwards if they want to shoot us more. So I feel they might do that. Oh, coming around the side. Okay. The other one might do a similar thing, or he might come further down the main entrance. No, leave Zycian alone. He's like our mascot. Good dodge. Yeah, definitely need to get Svogaz involved in this and get Zycian to retreat the hell out of there. As Don, how much do you like getting hit? Oh, I love getting hit. It's what I live for. Okay, if you insist. Aww. Well, at least we've wasted his dodge now.
A new round has started.
Right, now at least we've just got the one massive problem to deal with. Oh, miss is not a good start. At least we can do two blood offering attempts. And then a regular attack after that. Go on, sidestep. When it's Zycian's turn, we should retreat him and try and heal people up. So, weapons of destruction on... Svogaz first. As always, our most beneficial. Then on Azdon. And then on no one else, because we don't want to risk the extra curse chance. Just going to wait back here on dodge. Zycian, please just retreat. Disengage. And we're going to move you back behind here. Next turn you can, I don't know, switch weapons perhaps. They're now going after that weird stone. I think the poison gas in the area has worn off, so he doesn't mind moving around so much. Freak, reload. Do you fancy having an arch off? Because you could go after that guy. Or you could help with the big one. Go after the big one. A miss from there. He's the size of a truck. And it was an aimed shot. It's doubly not good. Right, one hit. Nice. Good. And then, for the love of God, parry. Parry like you've never parried before. Don't worry about it, Farik. You've had worse. Yeah, you probably haven't had worse than 2 arrows in the same spot, but... it's fine. Relatively, it's fine. We've got bigger issues, and I mean that quite literally and figuratively. Good dodge. Ah, ouch. And good dodge.
A new round has started.
Alright, let's get this bad boy down, shall we? Oh, so close. Sidestep, yeah. Tagom? Tagom, do you want to walk up and punch him? It seems like a really bad idea, and yet it seems like an okay-ish idea. Ah, the poison gas cloud is still there. Oh, but you could engage from this point. ...70% chance to hit. Bosh. Kill stealer to Gom. Well. Weapons of destruction on... Asdon. And hope we don't get a stunning curse area of effect thing. That would be really bad. Dumbfounded. That's... that could be a lot worse. Nothing worth looting on the leader. I don't really want to move too much closer to loot other stuff. What else do we have to loot in the area? There is, of course, all of the body bits from Juradash that he picked up. Could possibly run around the poison and get those. Yeah, okay, let's do that. Ah, that's Reinhardt. Where is Juradash? Next one over. My mistake. And then out of sight. Because out of sight, out of mind. Or something like that, anyway. Go on ambush. Just in case anyone does happen to run all the way around here. And Zycian, you're going to run out and try and poison globe up this guy. Ah, your poison area has worn off, actually. So this is pretty reasonable. Can you do it upstairs? That would be really nice. I don't think you can. Well, you can get it at that archer. So do that, and then get out of sight again. And you can sit on ambush stance just in case anyone tries to charge you somehow. Oh, they failed their route test. I guess taking out that impressive tipped us over the balance there. Oh, that was painful, wasn't it? Doesn't take very much at all for things to go wrong. Letting Juradash get taken out by a bad stun, followed by a bunch of attacks, followed by the impressive, very quickly led to a couple of spiraled deaths there.
Your ruthless ambition serves you well.
Yes, definitely ruthless ambition. Greedy is perhaps the word I would use to describe it.
Completed.
Well, crossing my fingers that he's all right. Nicely. Farik is doing all right. So, Gaz, again, MVP all day, every day. Tagom, Killstealer. Amok. Well, that's fine. Juradash already was crazed, so he would never retreat from combat anyway. This is basically a full recovery as far as he's concerned. To be honest, the guys probably can't tell the difference. Asdon is fine. And a light wound for Zycian. That's for being critically hit. Now, what's happened to Rytosh? Full recovery. Excellent. Just a couple of bruises. Not bad for your first outing. Ah, a couple of nice little things. Formula of Hunters. That could well be something to do with bows. Maybe rifles. The Blunderbuss might be able to be equipped on good old Zycian here. We shall have a check about that in a second. First up, pay for treatment for the scuffed knees. Pay for the warband. And then we can have a look at... Okay, ooh, we've achieved a new veteran rank. Let's do that before we forget about it. Come on, veteran system. Let's have a look. Skills. So, what could we do? We've already increased our librarian contact. I think what we might want to do is master a scholar to reduce our training costs even further. The other option is to go for better chances of more one-handed weapons. They are very, very nice. But for the moment, let's see if we can reduce the costs of training people up in new skills. Alright, now where was I? Zycian, can you use the blunderbuss? No, you can't. Well, in that case, we're going to need to sell that. There we go. Blunderbuss. Fires a cone attack. Nice. I guess that's probably a human weapon. We don't need 6 great axes. That's definitely too many. Everything else looks largely fine. No need to sell anything else there. Let's allocate people's stats. So, to Gom first. I think I was going for insult as a skill. Let's have a look. Yes, so I need 12 leadership for that. And Order will need 15 eventually. So let's boost leadership a bit more. And a weapon skill. I think weapon skill, yeah, we want to get that to maximum for the melee resistance. Juradash, you're going to get a little bit more alertness just so you move a bit faster. Let's go back to description, there we go. Zycian. You're going to get a bit more alertness, again, so you can move a bit faster. Rytosh, we're not going to allocate anything until we know what your first mutation is. So for the moment, you can sort of sit doing nothing. I suppose we could put a bit in accuracy. Yeah, why not? Just so you've got some benefit for your level up. Farik. I think we're going to increase your toughness just a little bit here. Agility is what we would normally do, but I'm starting to feel the pinch of the difficulty level just a little bit here and there. Svogaz. Think a bit more leadership. And I think that is everyone. Yes, it is. Cool. Back to camp. Have a quick look in the smuggler's den. We've got a shipment in transit at the moment, which should bring in some cash. So we could potentially send some people in for some training. Let's have a quick look at our archers. I think they've all got quick reload now. Yes, they do. So that's my first thought. We're going to need to bring Mordheim out in place of Zycian, just because of injuries for next time. So is there anything one turn based that we could train Mordheim up in? Like Fatality? That's 2 days. No, I don't really want to take 2 days on that for the moment. Not quite yet, anyway. Fine, we will leave all of that for the moment. And just see what happens overnight.
New hired swords are available.
Okay, so two warriors are receiving treatment for their injuries. That's Eladel from last match and Zycian from this match. New hired swords are available. Let's have a look and see who is on the carousel. And Thorgar, leader. Temion, I think he was there before. Hervar is new. He's got giant eye in his chest. The eye. Better initiative, good critical resistance. It's kind of okay. Ovis has definitely been seen before. And we've got Gornag and Arashiel. Well, we're not interested in any of these guys, so we will give them all a swift pass. And that's going to bring us to the end of this day. Thank you very much for watching, everyone. I hope you've enjoyed this as much as I have. And will be joining me for the next episode. Remember to like this video if you've liked it and subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. And I will see you next time for another day in Mordheim, City of the Damned.